Joe always says that it's, and it's true, you know, as crazy as it is, it's the best thing that ever happened in my career. I was training at Joe's gym. We were rolling Jiu Jitsu. I wasn't wearing a cup. And he went to try and pass my guard. And if you don't do Jiu Jitsu, what he tried to do was like a knee cut pass where you bring your knee up and you try and slide it between the two legs of your opponent to try and get into side control position. And basically, as he did that, the knee came up. Instead of cutting past my legs, I may have moved a little bit to try and recover guard. All the stars aligned in the most gruesome way. And then he came straight down and it basically like sandwiched one of my testicles and it ruptured it. So I like laid on the floor. There's audio of it. There's two teammates that were training at Joe's filming their own rounds, but you heard it in the background. I yell out a bit and I laid on the floor for a while, went and took a shower. I had to like hold myself to support myself because it was like so painful. And it felt like there was like a unicorn horn on it. It was horrible. It took me a day and a half to actually go get seen. I tried to go get seen right away. I went to like a walk-in clinic right next to Joe's gym. But with the UFC, the insurance only covers training-related injuries. So it's not like a normal insurance. And they shooed me away. They're like, no, this doesn't work. Even though the UFC would have paid 100%, which they did pay for everything with the surgery, aside from a $1,500 deductible. But they shooed me away. So I went home, tried to have a couple of drinks and like shake it off. And a day and a half later, everyone, because I made a post asking if anyone had been like hit real bad there before, everyone was saying, go see the doctor. And I did. They did an ultrasound. And then the doctor came in, they just asked me what I had to eat or drink, which is like code for you're going in for surgery. So they called an emergency surgery. The surgeon came in, I drove there, or actually I was taken away in an ambulance, which is where I got all the publicity because I asked if I could take a picture with them. And I made a pretty positive post, I think, for it. But yeah, then I went in for surgery and then I got on TMZ and I got on the Jim Rome show, Ariel Helwani show, Barstool Sports, all this stuff. So, you know, it was good in the long run. It was only a month recovery. Now I have permanent stitches, metal stitches in me for the rest of my life. But you know, it's all my testosterone levels were normal. The after a year, I think, is when I tested them. I don't know. Maybe I'll test them again one day. But from what they say, you don't even need the other one. If you want to know, like, the gruesome details of it, what you can equate it to is, like, if you hit a baseball and it explodes, how the stitching can come out. So some of that came out of the testicle on the inside, and what came out, what they couldn't get back inside, they cut out. And then they stitched it back together. And then, you know, the cover over that got stitched back or glued back together. And the stitches that are inside have to stay forever. So yeah, it was rough, but, you know, a lot of pain for the first handful of days, and then it subsided. After a month, I was back to training pretty hard, though.